Good morning. Psalm 94, verse 8 says, "Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous songs." So we welcome you to our worship service today at Kilmarnock United Methodist Church. I am Pastor Penny Corey. And we also want to welcome any visitors that are here. If this is your first time with us, if you'll raise your hand, we'd like to give you one of our welcome cups. Slater, we have a couple up here. Please also fill out the visitor card in the pew racks for us. We're glad that you're here. We have a special greeting to all who are mothers, and also to all of the women who love others with a mother's love. We would like to thank all of the women of the church for their love. whether you have actually given birth to a child or whether you have just nurtured others by your love and your care, we give thanks to God for you. Well, I picked up a book at the yard sale yesterday. Can't imagine that, can you? It was a Mother's Day book and called Mothers Are Forever. It was a delightful little book honoring motherhood. So I'd like to share some quotes from the book. This is a quote from Eleanor Roosevelt. She says, "Of all the rights, the greatest one is to be a mother. A good mother does more than just give birth. She shapes life." Dolly Parton said, "Nothing is as precious as my mama's memory." Arnold Schwarzenegger says, "I have one of the best mothers anyone could have." John Travolta said, "My mom liked to inspire creativity in her children. Our happiness was important to her." Natalie Cole said, "My father was always on the road to a great deal, and my mother, she ran the family." Reba McIntyre said, "It used to get me when Mama, who was my biggest critic, was in the audience when I was singing. But now that I'm a mama myself, I realize that she loves me regardless of how I do." Elvis Presley said, "I loved my mama. She was always my best gal." Kay Arthur, who is a spiritual author and poet, said, "Love has its source in God, for love is the very essence of God's being." So when I think about love, I think about my mother who has raised me, cared for me and my family. I'm also thankful for her love that she showed to the community and to the church and to anyone she met, for she shared the love of God with others. I miss my mama every day, and somehow I still feel her prayers and her love is all around me. And I know that many of you will echo this feeling today. Thank you for all who worked so hard to prepare for the church yard sale, and for all who volunteered all day Saturday to help. It was a great day of fun and fellowship. We will have a total of the amount that we received, and we'll send that out in a congregational email this week. I'd also like to say a big thank you to anybody who donated items for the yard sale, for the bake sale, or for the silent auction. We could not have done it without your help. We also like to say a big thank you to Sherry Bennett and Sally McGrath, who helped us organize this big event. It's all for the glory of God, and the money that we'll receive will go back into community missions. From Mother's Day to Father's Day, the United Methodist Church always receives a special offering. It's called the Samaritan Fund Offering. It is a benevolence fund that provides financial assistance to our senior residents in our United Methodist retirement homes. It helps those seniors who have outlived their monetary resources and through no fault of their own can no longer afford the cost of their care. So by your generosity, you support those whose finances have been depleted, and you allow them the opportunity to stay in these retirement homes to be taken care of until their death. The Samaritan program is an excellent way to give peace of mind to our most vulnerable senior residents who are in need of financial assistance. We will receive this offering from May 14th through June 18th. You may give by writing a check to KUMC and on the memo line if you would write Samaritan Program. On next Sunday, May 21st, we'll receive new members to our church. So if any of you are here today and would like to join our KUMC membership, please talk to me this week. Also, next Sunday, plan to stay after our 11 o'clock worship for the fellowship hour to meet our new members. The chancel flowers this morning are given to the glory of God by Jim and Tammy Crandall in loving memory of their moms, Emma Mae Purcell and Sharon Crandall, and their father, Top Purcell, on his birthday. We ask for all of you to register your attendance, please, in the pads that are at the end of the pew. Send them down and then back to the center with us, and then we would appreciate that, please. Let us stand for our call to worship. Good morning, God. Incite us and enable us by your Holy Spirit to improve the time in which you shall give to us, to avoid all evil thoughts, deeds, words, and actions, and to do all the duties which you shall set before us. Hear our prayer, O Lord, for the sake of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray together. O dear God, this is the day the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. O Lord, we choose to give you our frailties and to move forward in your strength. Your promise in the Holy Word preserves our lives and lifts us up so that we can learn through our struggles and trials that you are sovereign God. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We invite you to turn in your hymnals to 384 as we sing Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
Thank you. Day song. So they are excited to share it with you. So please enjoy and know how special you all are to us as women, loving, nurturing, godly figures and role models.
Thank you, children. That was awesome. It is now time that we share our praise and thanks to God. And so if you have filled out one of the prayer cards in the pew, if you'll hand those up, someone will pick those up for us. I have two prayers up here. One is for a prayer for my brother, Arthur Duke, who fell from his farm equipment and tore his rotator cuff. So he will have to have surgery on July the 5th. Also prayers for Taylor Deal. Many of you know that is the daughter of our church secretary, Joanne Henson. Taylor is due to have her baby at the end of May. Sarah Wallenborn says, please pray for her because she is putting her property up for sale by the end of May, and she will be moving closer to her parents who live in Charlottesville. And Judy Altier asks prayers for my friend Karen Jones, who sees an orthopedic surgeon on Thursday, and that he can operate on her knee so she'll be able to walk with the walker. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer. Oh, dear Almighty God, Creator of all things, thank you for this day. It is a beautiful day. It is a gift. It is a holy day. It is a day that we celebrate mothers and women. Thank you for the mothers who have given birth to us, and bless all of the mothers and the women who have nurtured other people's children. Pour out your spirit on them and bless them today. Comfort and care for all mothers who grieve the loss of a child. Surround them with your love. May the splendor of heaven visit us in a fresh new way. We receive these gifts from God, his presence, peace, power, and protection. We receive his rest, refreshment, renewal, and restoration. Oh Lord, help us to be your disciples, bearing fruit for your kingdom. Enlarge our field of vision. For Lord, we know we are never alone in the task that you have given to us. You are our strength and our help. Your kingdom come, your will be done, nothing more, nothing less, nothing else. May Jesus Christ increase in us. Oh God, hear the prayers of our heart today, especially for the ones that we have lifted up this morning. Hear our prayers, those spoken and those unspoken. Reach out with love, grace, mercy, comfort, and healing. Oh, great King of love, let the leaves of the tree of life bring healing to your people. Send your comfort to those who are grieving. We're thankful for the men and the women who serve in our armed forces to keep our country and our world safe. Bless all of our governmental leaders with wisdom and keep them on the path of truth and freedom. Lord, bless this congregation of Christians here at KUMC and keep us as the apple of your eye. Keep us serving. Keep us growing in our faith. Bless our missionaries serving around the world as they share the love, forgiveness, and salvation of Jesus Christ with others. New every morning is your love, great God of light. Stir us up with a desire to serve you, to live peacefully with our neighbors, and to devote each day to your Son, our Savior and risen Lord, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We invite you to turn in your hymnals to 881. Let us stand and affirm our faith together by saying the Apostles' Creed, and then let us sing our Gloria Patri on page 70. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty, from thence shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Unto God, let the ushers come. Let us pray. Dear God, bless the gift and the giver and multiply these gifts for the kingdom's use and through our church. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
To us by your word. Take the truth of your word and plant it deep in us. Shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ and the glory of God might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all of your purposes for your glory. Amen.
Amen.
I'll be reading from Psalm 31, 1 through 5. In you, Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Turn your ear to me. Come quickly to my rescue. Be my rock of refuge, a strong fortress to save me. Since you are my rock and my fortress, for the sake of your name, lead and guide me. Keep me free from the trap that is set for me, for you are my refuge. Into your hands I commit my spirit. Deliver me, Lord, my faithful God. But I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God. My times are in your hands. Deliver me from the hands of my enemies, from those who pursue me. Let your face shine on your servant. Save me in your unfailing love. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
The title of my sermon today is, Whose Time Is It Anyway? Let us pray. Oh God, open our hearts to receive your message and your comfort from these troubling times in which we live. Give us understanding and revelation to put your truths into practice in our lives. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock, my redeemer, my deliverer. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So Psalm 31 is one of the three psalms that appears in the story of Jesus' passion and death on the cross. The words of this psalm express the emotional turmoil experienced at a time of feeling rejected and betrayed. Verse 5 specifically appears in Luke 23, verse 46, when Jesus said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." But as we look at this whole entire Psalm of 31, it provides a backdrop for Jesus' passion. The psalmist is overtaken by the forces of suffering and pain and death. For this psalmist, his enemies seem to be having their way in his life. And so he's very honest with God, and he asks God, "Please intervene. Transform this situation." And he said, "My times are in your hand. Deliver me from my enemies and from those who pursue me." This psalm is a prayer by one who knows about suffering and knows that through suffering, they can put their complete trust in God. Because of who God has already shown himself to be in King David's life, he prayerfully pours out his heart to God, and he asks God to continue to keep him safe. David lays all of his mental, physical, and emotional hurts before God, and he cries out, "Oh Lord, have mercy on me." In the second half of the psalm, David speaks of God's comfort after the pain, saying to God, "No matter what, no matter what happens to me, I am going to put my trust in you, for you are my God, and I confidently place my life into your caring hands." David makes a decision to rely on God in hard and threatening times. Have you been in the same place? You've been in a hard place in your life. You can't understand what's going on in life. And you say to God, "Here I am. I'm yours. Take me, use me, show me the way, Lord." There is a hymn, "Be Still My Soul," that was written in 1752 by Katharina von Schlegel in Germany. For our prelude this morning, our organist played this beautiful hymn for us. Little is known about the author of this hymn, but this hymn, as we look at it, expresses a deep faithfulness, a faithfulness to the scriptures, a faithfulness to her personal relationship with God, a faithfulness to know that God is holding everything in the palm of his hand and is in control even of difficult situations. God shows his power through pain, and he promises he will rescue and provide for his people. For out of agitated and tumultuous times, this hymn brings a serenity of the melody we know as Finlandia, symbolizing hope and resolution. This is a hymn for us to sing any time that we are going through a tough time in our lives. Listen to just the words from the first verse. "Be still, my soul, the Lord is on your side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to your God to order and provide. In every change, God faithful will remain." Oh, be still, my soul. Your best, your heavenly friend, through thorny ways, leads to a joyful end. Have you ever asked the question, just who is in control of my crazy life? At times, all of us are bombarded by challenging times, and we, like the psalmist, have probably cried out, what's going on in my life? Well, I want to ask you this morning, what if we rephrase that question? Instead of asking the what question, we ask, whose time is it anyway? For the psalmist emphatically gives the answer to that question. He said, my times are in your hands. So, time does not belong to us. Time belongs to God. He just lets us have a part in His time. God created the world and all that is in it. God created you, and God created me. But rather than saying our time does not belong to us, perhaps we should say our time does not belong to us. This makes it personal. The conversation is suddenly about our lives 24/7. The next hours of our personal and our work time is in the hands of God. I want you to imagine your life right in the palm of God's hands. When we think of life in this way, it changes everything. We are not on our time. We are on God's time. And as our faith in God grows, we also, like the psalmist, cry out. We cry out to God and say, turn your ear towards me, O God. I know you're there, God. Come and rescue me. Oh God, be my rock of refuge. Be my strong fortress to save me for the sake of your name. Lead me, guide me. Free me from the trap that is set for me by the evil one, for you are my refuge in times of trouble. So we too, like the psalmist, and we too, like Jesus, can say, oh Lord, my faithful God, into your hands I commit my spirit. Oh my Lord, my faithful God, thank you that you made me with a purpose and a plan. David had a personal relationship with his God, the one true God, Yahweh, who listened to him, who rescued him, who delivered him, and redeemed him over and over and over again in life. David clearly proclaims in verse 21, blessed be the Lord, for he has wondrously shown his steadfast love to me. So David, even if it is sometimes reluctantly, David surrendered his life into the providential care and the protection of God. So now I would ask a personal question to each of us. How is it with your life? Who's in control of your life? Are you in the driver's seat? Or is God in the driver's seat? Do you have the kind of personal relationship with God that David did? I wanted to tell you this morning, my friends, that life is not left to fate. Your life is precious to God. You are so precious to God that He sent His own Son, dear Jesus Christ, to love you, to save you, to rescue you, to forgive you of your sins, and to give you hope. Say John 3:16 with me. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Do you know this morning for sure that when you die, you will go to heaven? I want to tell you this morning, you can know the answer to that question. Be like the psalmist David. Just honestly talk to God. Express your desire to place your life in God's sovereign hands today. For God is good, and He desires good plans for your life. Listen again to the words of David in Psalm 31, verses 14 to 16. But I trust in You, Lord. I say, You are my God. My times are in Your hand. Deliver me from my enemies and from those who pursue me. Let Your smiling face shine upon Your servant and save me in Your unfailing love and look with favor on my life. Tomorrow is never guaranteed. In fact, the next second of your life is never guaranteed. The future is uncertain for all of us. Just read the newspaper or turn on the daily news. David makes it clear in Psalm 31 that he is in need of intervention by saying, take me out of the net of the evil one. So today, can you believe that your hand is in the Almighty God's hands? Can you give your life over to God's custody, knowing that He is a good and faithful God? Can we give our spirits over to God, knowing that God knows what's best for us anyway? I know that this is an act of absolute, complete trust in God and a willingness to follow God's ways and not our own human ways. So will you say to God this morning, God, I want to be one of Your people. I need You, O God. I want to follow You with all my heart, mind, soul, and strength. Where You lead, I will follow. Help me to live according to Your truth. I want to live a life of faithfulness. Forgive me of my sins and my foolish ways. May I lead a life like Your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in all that I do and all that I say. If you prayed that prayer this morning, honestly from your heart, you can know that you are saved by God's amazing grace and that you have an eternal home in heaven. Now, God has given you a manual for how to live your life in God's ways. That manual is His holy word. Spend time with God in His word. Praise God every day. Talk to Him as you would talk to your closest friend. Psalm 31 closes with this encouragement for our lives. Be strong and take heart, all you who hope in the Lord. So we will return to the question that I asked at the beginning of the sermon. Whose time is it anyway? It's God's time. I want you to dream as if you'll live forever. but I want you to live your life as if you'll die today. Let us pray. Dear God, we are your people called by your name. We commit ourselves totally to you. Thank you that my destiny, my future, and every moment of my life is in your trustworthy hands. Thank you for David's message to us in Psalm 31 today. Into your hands, O Lord, God of truth and life, we commit our spirits to you. We know that you are victorious every time over the enemy of our lives. Thank you, Jesus, for giving your life, for shedding your blood on the cross just for each and every one of us. Thank you, Jesus, for loving us and making a way where there seems to be no way. We trust you. We pray this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I invite you to sing hymn number 337. Him is only trust him. As you're singing these words, don't just sing the words. Make this song a prayer. Let us stand and sing, only trust him. Shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. We pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And the people of God said, Amen. Amen.